can get West Barnes Marching Band preview. This is our second annual preview. We actually began this process last year. We enjoyed it so much, and we wanted to do it again. This year, as you will notice, again, the band is significantly larger than we were last year. Again, we have even grown by another 20%. So, great numbers again out here. Our staff and again, these students member have spent over the past 3 weeks approximately 200 hours preparing what we are going to prepare for you today. Color guard and our percussionist, they have actually been with us 3 weeks, and our wind players, those guys have been with us for 2 weeks now. For the past 2 weeks, we have been running from 8 a.m. until 8 p.m. each day. And these guys have literally only had about 2 hours break a day. An hour for lunch, and then approximately an hour for dinner, and then they have been back at work. So this is an extremely hardworking group of students, and we are very proud of the work that they have done.
What I would like to take a second before we get started,
I would like to acknowledge some people that we could not accomplish this goal without them, and that is our staff. Some of them are down on the field, so I'd like to acknowledge those. Mr. Hyman, again, is down on the field. Again, if you would just hold his hand there. For those that do not know, Mr. Hyman is the band director at Moore Middle School. If your child is entering into Moore Middle School, I would highly encourage them to join band with Mr. Hyman. And just so you can see the number of students again, that are from Moore Middle School, if you are on the field currently for West Lawrence Center Marching Band, if you came from Moore Middle School or currently are in Moore Middle School, Mr. Hyman has spent a lot of time over the past 2 weeks fixing our fundamentals. Getting our young marchers out in the baking sun. We are very, very appreciative of him. We also had a new percussion instructor this year. Dr. Reeves is a percussion instructor at Francis Marion University, and we are blessed to have him. He has done a massive amount of work. In fact, he is working with approximately 26 students between front ensemble and battery, and is essentially doing two jobs by one person. So we're very, very appreciative for him. Our other person is actually up here on the top, back here in the press box with me, and that is, again, Mr. Coleman Wright. Mr. Wright is actually a graduate of West Lawrence High School. He was a drum major, and we are very, very blessed to have them working with our woodwinds. But of course, these 2 weeks, we have really enjoyed his tutelage, and certainly welcome him back anytime. We have also had two members on our guard staff, and I don't know if they're placement. One over there, and I know very well, which is my wife, Ms. Amber Powers. She is over here to your left. And a newcomer to our staff, Ms. Rebecca Ricks. Those two have been a nice dream team who have been working with our guard on flag work and soon to be weapon work, but also in dance. So you'll see some elements of those in just a little bit today. Just so that everybody knows, these students, most of them that came in, I also want to preface this. Raise your hand if you are brand new to the band this year, brand new to marching band. You have never done this before. Yeah. We have a massive amount of new students as we kind of start. And it is a very daunting task to do marching band for the first time. It's very scary because they're approaching something brand new. Most of them, I think, came in very timid and very shy. Over the past 200 hours, they have come out of the shell. Some of them maybe too much. But they have come out of the shell nonetheless. And we are, again, very, very pleased to have them. Before we get started, I also want to acknowledge our athletic director, Mr. Greg Johnson, for allowing us to use this beautiful performance space for our preview. Also, our principal, Mr. Matthew Dowdell, here at West Lawrence. And also, of course, our fine arts coordinator, Dr. Eric Figueres, and our wonderful superintendent, Dr. Richard O'Malley. We will also have a wonderful cookout back there, and parents can show your students how to do it right.
Whenever you're ready.
This group of young musicians, they have spent a lot
And as our color guard is making their way on out, they have some items again to showcase for you. Remember, our color guard, again, I think what is most impressive about this color guard is the number of returning members and also new members. This group, again, has, again, another massive majority of new members, but, again, this group has worked extremely hard, and like I said, they are very, very impressive, and we're excited to see you in their showcase. That you will see, again, parents, if you actually look over the front edge, again, of the stadium edge here, and you can see down onto the ground where the students are, you'll notice that these students, again, have all these instruments, again, perfectly in lines. You'll notice that these students, again, have water jugs in line, again, bags that are organized. And part of, again, our other process has been discipline. Discipline for a marching band is one of the most important, again, things that we can get. And again, through that process, by teaching students, again, how to organize the smallest of items, water jugs, bags, Patience for us, we shall get there in 2 seconds. For all of our parents who need to be new members, I do want to acknowledge a couple of things that the band will be doing along the way. Members of the band, again, they are going to air for you tonight our performance show, our 22-23 show. And the competitive show that we do will take five competitions. We will start our competition season early September 17th. We will actually make a long trek up to Powderville High School.
Then the following weekend, these guys will actually move to Hartsville High School. The next weekend we will have an off weekend, and then we will travel to River Bluff High School. And then the last two contests are the things we work for our entire season. We spend about three months preparing for lower state and state championships.
And our group, as of last year, we took this group to South Carolina State Championships, again placed in 11th place.
Take me as I am, swear I'll do
Thank you. guys,
Let's get rolling.
Very good, man.